2 of Dapol's new releases, and this is the Class 68 diesel locomotive, and these are the ScotRail livery version, and they are the DCC ready models. The DCC fitted, that's with the decoder already fitted at the factory, and the DCC sound ones are due out very shortly, I think within 2 weeks of me filming this, but don't hold me to that. Now, this one I've yet to fit the decoder in, so at the moment it's on the programming track, which I've got a switch that can kill the power to this section, so there's no chance of the DCC burning this motor out. This one, however, has the decoder fitted, as you've seen it running, and we've used a Zimo decoder. It's the MX634D, and it's, as Dapol recommend, it's an MTC21 pin recommended decoder, and this has 6 functions in this decoder, which is one of the ones that Dapol recommend, and they recommend a 6 function decoder to get the best out of the lighting on this, because it is quite comprehensive. As you've seen, you have the working cab lights either end, working head and tail lights, and at the moment it has independently controlled lighting on this end, so we can turn the headlamps and the tail lamps off when hauling a consist, or if it's topping and tailing, you can have the rear lights on and no lights on at that end if that's at the back, and vice versa if it's one at the front. Now, with the cab lighting, you are able to remove the top part of the exhaust cowling here, and there's 2 switches underneath, and these control the cab lights, so you can have them turned on, off, or if the locomotive is topping and tailing, you can have it so when it's running with the loco behind, that when the cab lights is on, and so on. The full details are in the instructions. Now, on the instruction sheet, Dapol recommend some decoders here. So for the 6 function decoders, they're recommending a TCS, and it has to have the X suffix after the number, and for the Zimo, it has to have a D suffix after the number. The other ones they recommend here is the SU and lock part and stuff. They also recommend the Lens Silver 21 pin 5 function decoder, and then obviously you've got your 2 functions and your 4 functions. Now, what they're saying is to get the best out of the lighting, is that you may have to remap the decoder to get the best out of the lighting, unless your decoder happens to do it straight off. So what they suggest is, for a 6 function decoder, is to remap function 0 for the number 1 end, which is this end, that's number 2 end there. You can actually see on the cab doors the listed as 2, which is what. So for function 0 is to remap it, so we have the white and red tail lamps directional, so function 0 forward and function 0 reverse. And then they're saying for function 1 on the number 2 end, again it's the same as function 0 for directional, so we can have the white and red tail lamps on. However, what they're suggesting is for function 2 is to remap, and this will operate the halo lights, which at the moment I'm not able to show you till I can get this decoder remapped and I'll be able to show you them. Now, the other thing that Dapol say with these decoders is on with the functions. So if you have a 2 function decoder, what it'll be able to do or not do. So if you've got a 2 function decoder, you will not be able to operate the halo lights, but you will be able to operate the directional lighting, and obviously with the cab lights, with the switch, and it tells you switch 3, which I'll get onto in a minute, as to what position to set that for controlling the cab lighting. If you're using a 4-function decoder, again, it says you will not be able to operate the halo lamps, but it'll give you independent directional front and rear DCC controllable lights, and it'll be able to operate directionally a switch selects the front, off and rear. And again, it tells you on switch 3 what a position to set that to. And then finally, with the 6-function decoder, it tells you that you will be able to operate the halo lamps via these outputs here. Complete independent control of all the lighting and with the halo lights, and again what the switch is. For removing the body, it's a very simple process. There's 4 body clips as shown on this diagram here. So it's just a case of using either a thin piece of sort of stiff card shoved between the body and the chassis at each of these 4 points, or like a piece of plastic card. So you can sort of see about these points here, and the body will just slide off. Now, for the switches, which I'll put a photo now so you can see what it looks like with the body off, is this is what you see. So you've got your blanking plug for if you want to put your DCC decoder in, and above that there's 2 terminals which you can solder your loudspeaker wires onto. They're clearly labelled plus and minus. It tells in here what sort of speaker they recommend. So with the switches 1 and 2, which are below the exhaust cowling, as you can see here, there's 3 positions, and this basically runs through what they do. And then switch 3 and switch 4 and 5 are only accessible with the body off, and these basically tell you what position to set your switch to. So if you're using a 4 or 6 function decoder, set switch 3 to position 1. Now the other thing with switch 3 is that when you get the model, it'll be factory set to position 2. So for DCC, for the 4 or 6 function decoder, set it to position 1 at the top there. Switches 4 and 5, these basically control the end push-pull lighting control. So switch 4 controls the end lamps for number 1 end, and switch 5 controls end lamps at number 2 end. So if you're not using DCC, you can still manually turn the tail lamps off if you're hauling a train and you don't want the tail lamps on, or you've got the coaches or whatever coupled up behind. So you can see it's clearly tells you what's what there.